Okay, in this video, we're going to create a new pool, which is going to be used as a horizontal pool. Okay, before we begin, I went ahead and created a mock-up in SketchUp using the pool model. And what I've got is the various dimensions that are going to be important to use here. For example, 7.938 millimeters from the edge of the door to the center of this hole. And I've got two dimensions here, 38.1 millimeters to the center, to the edge of the model, and another one here, which is 68.1 from the center of the model to the edge of the door. Now, that could be pretty much, this is the value that could change, but you never want it to be less than the 38.1 because the model would extend beyond the door. So, for example, you can see here that if we move the door up and down, we can see that dimension changes. So that one's going to be more of a variable. Now let's go back into CV. We can see here that I've chosen pool type number one, and the length is the space between the holes, and the width and the depth are based on values that I found here at the model itself. The horizontal inset, that's going to be the distance from this hole to the center, from the center of the hole to the edge of the door, which is what we see here, and the vertical inset, which is the value that we see right here. Now, as I noted, that could be any value that you want. This can be a variable, and this one here cannot be a variable because that hole always has to be that distance to the edge. As we continue here, I just want to point out that this is going to be a pool that's going to get rotated horizontally, but we are going to create it initially as a pool that is rotated vertically like this. Okay, so now that we have our values in there, we'll go next. I did enter 3.2 for the whole diameter to match what we have here. And of course, that could be whatever you actually need it to be in your shop to fit the machining that you have. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and finish that. And that created our test pool. Let's go ahead and open that pool up. This is not the one that we're going to use eventually, but we're going to use this as an example on how to get started. So we'll go into the model editor. First thing I'm going to do is get rid of the parts that we don't need. So I'm going to right-click on each of these and choose Delete. So that leaves us with just the mounting holes, and we can see them. Now, what we want to do here is come in and measure from the center of this hole to here, and it's 12.7 by 7.938, which is what we have here. And we could go ahead and throw in a dimension here. So we can see that's 12.7. All right. So what we would do next is we would make sure come to one of the legitimate views there for the ortho views and click on the primary work plane. Now this would be the traditional first step, would be to insert the model here. However, we would have a problem with that because if we do, and I'm going to go ahead and add the hardware now. Okay, and all I'm going to do now is go ahead and put in some values to position it. Okay, so we have it roughly positioned. We'll look at it from the top and make sure that we've got it all the way So we're going to go, the Z is going to be minus 19.05 minus 1.6. Okay, so we've got that where we want it. Let's just look at it here in 3D. Now, if we were to use this, let's go ahead and close out of here. Close out of material properties. Now, we're going to go ahead and select that for this. Before we begin, let's go ahead and update this job. And we'll go back to job properties. We're going to reselect that particular model now. So there's the test pool, and we'll just put it on here. Okay, now if we were to look at the upper cabinet, you can see the upper cabinet is fine. Okay, so the upper cabinet is fine. The base cabinet needs to be rotated around. Okay, there are a couple of other changes that may need to be made to these, but that's the primary one right there. Let's go ahead and delete these two cabinets. And we'll just put one here and one here so they're a little bit easier to see. Okay, so the problem we have now is we need to rotate these pools here. Now, if we go in and look at that in the object tree. Okay, here's our pool, and here's our model. This is the pool chrome model that we inserted. This is the part that needs to rotate, but if we were to rotate that, we're going to have to write several formulas in order to rotate it and reposition it. So instead of doing that, what we're going to do is we're going to add a new work plane to that particular model, and then we're going to push our pool model onto that work plane. So we'll come back in here, we'll go to the front view, we'll click on primary work plane and click on add work plane. That inserted a new work plane called front work plane. You can see it's positioned out here. What we're going to do is change the X to 0, change the Y to 0. And now, with that, it is in the exact same location as the primary work plane. And we're going to do one more modification. We're going to go to the Z position, and we're going to say minus parent Z. Okay, now what that's going to do is that's going to push it back. We look down here, maybe we can see it from the top view. Yeah, so we can see our new work point is all the way to the back of the door. Okay, so let's go back to our front. We're going to take the pool, and I'm going to hold down the control key, drag it, drop it onto the front work point. So now that pool is on here. Now the advantage that gives us is that when we click on the front work plane, we can modify the Z position of that, the AZ. So if we rotate that all the way around, you can see that it's correct. So the thing is that with AZ at 0, this is correct for an upper cabinet. So we need to make it correct for base cabinet. So we'll come in here and we'll say if parent Y is greater than, say, 2 inches, then we're going to give it a value of 180. Okay, now when we test it here, it's going to say false. That's because while we're in the model editor, it cannot evaluate that. But when this model will appear on a base cabinet, the parent Y will be greater than 2 inches, and it will then evaluate properly. Okay, so we have that pretty much done. We're going to save it, exit all the way out, and then we'll go up here to Utilities, Update Job, and Update Materials. And we can see our models rotated for that one, and they stayed the same for the upper cabinets. So the key is that we created this as a vertically positioned pool. Now, in the material schedule for that pool schedule, we enabled rotate the door pool. We set that to yes. And what that did is that took the vertically aligned pool that we created and simply rotated it. So by doing that, we were able to avoid using a UCS. We were also able to avoid using a great deal of programming in order to get that to work.